Cheap, convenient, and absolutely delicious. No one does fast food like McDonald's. No matter what part of the world you're in, the quality and taste of a good old McDonald's meal remains unmatched. Very few restaurant chains have had a global impact as great as McDonald's, making it one of the largest businesses of all time. But how did McDonald's go from a single restaurant to the international brand that it is today? Let's find out. Before we continue, make sure to give this a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for notifications. Let's begin. The story of McDonald's starts from extremely humble beginnings. It was in 1984 when brothers Maurice and Richard McDonald laid the foundation of this expensive chain. And it might be hard to believe, but the very first McDonald's was a drive-through barbecue restaurant converted into a small burger and milkshake joint. Located in San Bernardino, California, this was the second time the two brothers tried to make it big in the food industry. And this time, they managed to do it pretty well. The original McDonald's had a simple menu. They focused on burgers, fries, and shakes, and sold them at half price than what their local competitors were charging. But how did the McDonald's brothers cut their costs so much? Well, by completely changing the way fast food restaurants work. Instead of hiring waiters and waitresses, McDonald's introduced a self-serving system. And to save time, instead of cooking each meal to order, they prepared their burgers ahead of time and kept the food warm under high-powered heat lamps. While this is pretty much how an average fast food restaurant works in this day and age, at the time, McDonald's was a pioneer in developing these techniques, helping it gain a huge edge over all its competition. The early success of McDonald's caught the attention of kitchen appliance salesman Ray Kroc, who supplied the restaurant with their appliances. Soon enough, Ray bought the franchising rights to McDonald's nationwide. Although at the time, the McDonald brothers had already licensed a couple of franchises in Arizona and California, it fell short and was not able to achieve any success remotely close to anything McDonald's has today, due to the lack of control over its quality. However, Ray Kroc had a bigger vision. In 1955, Kroc formed the McDonald's Corporation, and Kroc opened his first franchise restaurant in Des Plaines, Illinois, and established the chain as a business. While it was Maurice and Richard who started McDonald's, it was Ray Kroc who turned it into a global success. Kroc opened a bunch of franchises all over America, and it proved to be a game-changing strategy, because the chain was a huge success. He took one small restaurant and mass-marketed it to the point that by 1961, later, due to conflicting ideas on how the business should be run, as well as Kroc's fast-track expansion plan, a fed-up Kroc finally settled and bought out the founders with $1 million for each brother, and a handshake deal with a promise of royalties which never actually materialized. But that's another story for another video. There was so much drama involved that the story was actually turned into a movie. The brothers, after the settlement, got to keep their original restaurant, but due to copyright infringement, had to rename the restaurant Big M. And after that, Kroc later opened a competing McDonald's nearby that drove them and the first ever McDonald's out of business by the end of the decade, showing just how powerful the fast food chain had become under Kroc's leadership. In the following years, McDonald's launched its now iconic arched logo, along with the introduction of Ronald McDonald as the brand's mascot, both of which helped the chain gain global recognition. In 1965, McDonald's went public. At the same time, Ray Kroc was constantly perfecting his franchising techniques to efficiently make use of all the money that people invested into the chain. This meant that McDonald's wasn't really relying on selling burgers and shakes for its growth. Instead, it was working on building an elaborate real estate empire that would take the company's success far and wide. While Ray was increasing the corporation size and maintaining strict control of its products, McDonald's CFO Harry Sonneborn came up with a strategy that McDonald's continues to use today. Instead of making money by selling supplies to its franchises or doubling up on the royalties, the McDonald's Corporation became the landlord for all of its franchises. What this means is that the company would buy out properties and then lease them back to the franchisees, ensuring steady cash flow for the company, which it then uses to repeat the cycle to buy more property to lease out. But not only that, the company would also take a share from each franchise's yearly sales, something that no one had ever done in the franchising industry. Control was the name of the game, control over the quality, and control over the franchisee. By owning the property, Ray Kroc and the McDonald's Corporation had controlled over everything and was able to maintain the high standards of quality and ensure consistency between each outlet. Customers knew what they were getting when going to any McDonald's outlet. You wouldn't want a Big Mac that tastes different in every outlet, now would you? After coming up with this brilliant strategy, McDonald's expanded to Canada and opened its first international restaurant in the city in 1967, working on the same principles of franchising. The same year, McDonald's started investing a considerable amount of their money into marketing, which was another winning move. In 1967 alone, McDonald's spent $2.3 million, or about 1% of its sales, on its first national advertising campaign, which was a first for any fast food chain. The idea behind all McDonald's advertisements was to create a certain image for themselves. Through their ads, McDonald's promoted themselves as a family restaurant where everyone could have a great time. In fact, McDonald's had started to attract families and target children back in the early 1960s. The McDonald clown appeared in 1963, followed by the Happy Meal menu and plastic toys. Their outlets featured games and play areas for children, prompting more families to pick McDonald's over every other restaurant. McDonald's Happy Meals would include toys like popular Teeny Beanie Baby promotion in 1996 and 1997. The company also established a global marketing alliance with Disney Pixar in 1998, which added immensely to their marketing, with their targeted audience being young children watching all these movies. Not just that, but McDonald's opened its first drive-thru in the US in 1975, making it even more convenient for people to grab their favorite burgers within a few minutes. As far as their franchising went, McDonald's opened a restaurant in Pushkin Square, Moscow in 1990, which was seen as a symbolic moment in the end of the Cold War. According to the restaurant's website, it served more than 30,000 Russian citizens on the first day, and has since then remained one of Russia's most loved fast food chains. In the 90s, McDonald's also came up with the brilliant idea to expand their menu. And in 1993 came the first ever McCafe, offering customers a coffee place right inside McDonald's, helping the company cater to adults as much as it was catering to children. By the 2000s, McDonald's had acquired companies like Chipotle and Boston Market. The company continued to function on its successful franchising business model and had opened more than 11,000 restaurants outside the US, including Vietnam in 2013. With Big Macs being the staple fast food in all parts of the world, McDonald's continued to grow and expand in unimaginable ways, leaving all of its competition far behind. The reason behind McDonald's success is not just its delicious burgers and impeccable customer service. It was the fact that the corporation realized that when you buy into a franchise, you're buying into a business. While we all relate to the McDonald's brand and advertising, what most people don't realize is that what made the brand so successful was the foolproof franchising system, which allowed McDonald's to become more efficient, more productive, and more profitable, and therefore allowed it to lower its costs, helping it offer more to its customers than the restaurant's competition ever could. While McDonald's has constantly improved its menu with additions like their all-day breakfast, salads, yogurt parfaits, and premium coffees, the backbone of the restaurant's success has always remained the business model. As of now, McDonald's keeps close to 82% of all their franchise-generated revenue, versus only 16% of its company-operated restaurant revenue, showing just how successful their strategy has been. With over 37,000 franchises all over the world, to this day, McDonald's is both a fast food and real estate business, showing just how diversification has contributed to the chain's success without any financial risks. Whether it's customer experience or product development, since the beginning of time, franchises have been instrumental to the growth of McDonald's. Having the foundation of consistent processes allows businesses the flexibility to innovate and adapt to consumers' concerns and improve the brand with minimal disruption, which is how McDonald's has remained consistent with its success over the span of so many years. McDonald's was able to achieve its huge success by building a strong brand and having a smart business strategy that holds true till this day. As far as the future is concerned, the company is planning on spending $6 billion on all of its national and international franchises to modernize their functionings, offering their customers even better experiences. With a current net worth of $163 billion and the restaurant's constant plans to expand as per its traditional growth strategy, it's evident that McDonald's will continue to dominate the fast food industry for many years to come. So, what do you think about the rise of the McDonald's empire? Ruthless? Would you have done this same thing if you were in Ray Kroc's position? Do let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell icon for future notifications. Be inspired, and we will see you in the next one. If you would like a more in-depth look at how McDonald's actually makes money, click the video on the left. Or if you would like to find out about other companies that were able to scale up their business empires into massive giants, click the video on the right.